This screencast is a simple review of stoichiometry. Let's take a combustion reaction. We have methane. It's combusted with some amount of oxygen, and we come out with carbon dioxide and water. Let's try and balance this. Since the hydrogens have to balance, we have four hydrogens over here, so we have to put a 2, 4, 4 hydrogens here. We have one carbon here and one carbon here, so we can leave it as one carbon dioxide. Now let's count out the oxygens. On the right-hand side, we have four oxygens, so we need to have four oxygens here. And the way to do that is to put a 2 in front of the O2. Let's try another compound. We're going to look at methanol. We're going to combust it with some amount of oxygen. And again, we're going to get CO2 and H2O. Over here, we have four hydrogens, so we put a 2 here. We have one carbon, so we leave CO2 the way it is. And again, over here, we have our four oxygens. We already have one oxygen from the methanol. So in order to balance this reaction, you would have 3/2 of O2. And by the way, it's always best to write a combustion reaction in terms of 1 mole of fuel, since property data is tabulated that way. Now let's look at limiting and excess reactants. So if we look at our first reaction up here, if you notice from the stoichiometry, for every 1 mole of methane, we're going to need 2 moles of oxygen. Let's say we have 3 moles of methane. In addition, we have 3 moles of oxygen. Which is limiting? Well, for 3 moles of methane, we would need 6 moles of O2 because of the stoichiometry of the reaction. However, we only have 3 moles of oxygen, so it's the limiting reactant. So let's see how much methane we would use up. So for 2 moles, we would use 1 mole of methane. So for 3 moles of oxygen, we would end up using 1.5 moles of methane. So what do we have left over? We have 1.5 moles of excess. By the way, when we're talking about combustion, we generally have excess oxygen in the form of air. So if we have 1 mole of methane and it reacts with 100% excess oxygen, 2 moles is the stoichiometric amount. So 100% would mean that we have 4 moles of O2. 50% excess would mean 3 moles. What would 200% excess oxygen end up being? I hope you said that it's 6 moles of O2 for 200% excess.